Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, your boy Virtus here, and welcome back to my Unreal Engine 4 animation series. In today's video, we are going to be introducing you to blend spaces, breaking them down, and talking about how they can be used within the animation process. We're also going to be taking a look at the two different types of blend spaces, so a normal blend space and a blend space 1D, looking at the differences and also how we can create the two of those. So for those of you that don't know what a blend space is, the best way I can show you is by opening one up. Once again, you can find a blend space inside of the animation starter pack, and a blend space is going to have this light orange little bar underneath it, and it's usually going to have the name or the letters BS before that. So just go ahead and open up one of these, and you're going to be taken into the animation tab, the same one as we showed you in the last video. Now, everything else is going to be the same, however, what you're going to have is a little grid down here. Now, essentially, what this grid is doing is essentially blending between animations depending on the data on this grid. So as you can see on this grid at the moment, you've got a little line at the bottom here and a line going up. So you've got a horizontal axis and also a vertical axis. And those two pieces of information are speed and direction. So on the direction bit, if I hold down shift and then move my mouse, as I move this on the grid, you can see essentially what it's doing is changing the direction that the player is walking in. And the way that it's doing this is by having a bunch of different animations plotted on the grid based on the direction information that's being given. So in the center here, we've got direction 0 and speed 0. Move it over here, we've then got direction 180, direction minus 180 on the opposite side, and you can really start to see exactly what's going on here. If I have my speed all the way at the top, he's going to move quicker, and he's just going to do all of that kind of good stuff. Now, you guys are really going to start to see this come to life as we create our own blend space, but essentially what you need to know for now is that a blend space is going to allow you to blend and swap between animations quite easily, depending on some variable information, such as the speed and the direction, and that's generally what you're going to be using a blend space for. So, this blend space that you've just seen here is a regular blend space, and it can sort of go with two axes. What you can also have is a blend space 1D, which is just going to have one axis. So let me show you how you can create one of these. Now, if you ever want to make a blend space, it's pretty straightforward. Right click in your content browser, and then go to animation, and then down here, you've got the two blend space options. Blend space 1D, and then just a regular blend space. So the one that we just saw there was a regular blend space, and with that we was able to have a horizontal and a vertical axis, so we can have two pieces of information, so speed and direction, whereas the blend space 1D is only going to allow us to have one type of information, so we could only have speed. So for example, if you've got a game where you're only going to be walking forwards, then a blend space 1D is going to do that just perfectly. So create your blend space 1D, and then from here, it's going to ask you to choose a skeleton. Now from here, we've got two. We've got one from the animation starter pack, and one that came with the engine. Just use the one at the top, which should be the one from your animation starter pack, and give your name, your blend space, the name test blend space, and then just open it up. So once you've got in here, you've got your graph, and there shouldn't be anything on here. And also notice your little sort of information, your little label for this little graph here has got nothing in there, so we need to assign that. So essentially, the way we're going to do this is by going up to Axis Settings in the top left-hand corner under Asset Details, and then from here, what you can do is you can give this the name, so that when you're working with this within an animation blueprint, you know exactly what it is. So for us, this is simply going to be speed, and once we type this in here, you are going to notice it now says speed at the bottom. We've got our minimum and maximum axis values. Essentially, what these do are these are going to allow you to sort of define your minimum and your maximum for your speed. So with the character movement, with our speed, generally the maximum is going to be 600, as that's what's determined within the character movement component. So my minimum is going to be 0, which is a stop. My maximum is going to be 600. And now, in our little graph at the bottom here, you can see we're going from 0 to 600 along there. And now all we've got to do is just plot some animations along the way. Putting these animations into this blend space is really easy. And by the time we've done this animation, we're going to have the basic setup for sort of jogging and running and so on. So what I'm going to do is start off with an idle animation at 0. So in my asset browser, in the bottom right hand corner, I'm going to find an idle animation. So what I'm going to do is idle, rifle hip, I'm going to put this into my 0. And what I did there was simply just drag it all the way to the left here. And then what I'm going to do is find myself a jog forwards with my rifle and put this into the middle. And our graph is going from left to right, so sort of in the middle is going to be speed 300, that's sort of there. And if you want to test this and see it coming to life, hold down shift, and then with your mouse you can move it along the graph to preview how that animation is going to be played depending on the speed. So if I put this over to 0, he's not going to be moving. Move it over to 300, he's going to be jogging. And then what I want to do is find a sprint forwards at 600 and drag this in here. So now if I hold down shift, go to the end, you can see my dude is starting to sprint. So what you should have now is a pretty cool blend space where your character is going to be forwards, and we're going to be going forwards, and depending on the speed, we are going to be able to make it play a different animation. Now, as of right now, this is not going to be something that you're going to be able to see in your game. We've actually got to hook this blend space up to an animation blueprint and also the variable for speed, but that's something that we're going to be doing over the next few videos. But for now, I'm going to end it here, and I hope you guys have enjoyed my brief introduction to blend spaces and how you can use them. Once again, guys, thanks for watching, stay awesome, keep creating. Your boy Virtus, signing out. This video was made possible by my supporters on Patreon. If you want more videos like this, check out my Patreon page using the link in the description. To stay up to date on new releases, make sure you follow us on social media.